Before we proceed in this tutorial, and if you are new here and wanted to learn something new, please consider subscribing to my channel and turn on the notification bell to keep you updated on my future tutorials about the Java programming language.
Alright, in this tutorial we're gonna set up JavaFX and scene builder in NetBeans IDE. So let's get started. The first thing we need to do is to download the JDK or Java Development Kit. Let's go to Google and search for Java Development Kit or JDK 16. You can download the latest JDK at oracle.com or azure.com. You also need the JavaFX SDK. You can download that. OpenJFX.io. After you downloaded the JDK, then go to your NetBeans IDE. In the tools, click on the libraries to add a global library for JavaFX SDK. Let me demo on how to add it. Hit an OK when you are done adding it. I'm gonna remove mine because I already have one. Alright, let's create a new JavaFX application. Choose the Java with Ant. Now go to the properties. Oh, I forgot to demonstrate on adding the JDK. Click on Java platforms. You can add a JDK here. This is from Julu Open JDK and this one is from Oracle. Add platforms to add a new JDK and select the Java Standard Edition. This one is from Oracle, and we'll find the other one from Azure, the Julu OpenJDK. Hit on finish on your side when you're done adding it. I'm gonna cancel it because I already have one. Let's go back to the properties. We will add a global JavaFX SDK. At the compile tab, you're gonna add the global library at the class path. On the Run tab, add the global library at the module path. On the VM options, we will add some path here if we encounter an error when running the project. Open this FXML to the scene builder. We'll need to download the scene builder. Back again to NetBeans, then locate the scene builder.txt here.
That's it for today. I hope you have learned something new in this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share. See you on the next video.